Jumbo is a over 40-year-old company. It started as a distributor. It in fact, in its in the peak days of Sony as a brand, it was the world's largest distributor of Sony. And so its origin is actually of that as a distributor. It was a distributor for Sony, Casio, Brother, Ricoh, many such brands. Always a large distributor. We, even today, majority of our business is distribution. However, over the years, somewhere in the about 20, 25 years ago, we upgraded our retail to a multi-brand retail. Jumbo was always was a company started by a high-end entrepreneur, Mr. Chhabria. He started this company, and this person had the ability to take risks, put his money where his mouth is, and he did extremely well here and in many other parts of the world. But he was highly professionally oriented. He always hired top-notch professionals. So you would see that right from 70s or 80s and 90s, the division heads, these are the guys who run, they're like the CEO of a business, were always brought from multinationals. Good thing about Jumbo is that it was a very fertile ground for entrepreneurship. He was always professionally oriented. The company was always run professionally. He would intervene only once a month and measure the plans versus actuals and give his directions. But rest of the month, he would allow the company to function. And the reason I brought you to this is that in the 90s, he got McKinsey involved, paid them a hefty sum in 90s that I want you to recommend to me as to where should I go next as a business. And at that time, Jumbo was mainly a consumer electronics. I then told him that you have a strength in retail. So you should get into retail first and then distribution. So then he started IT distribution with Compaq, later on with IBM and others. So it was always a professionally run company. And your point, now coming to your question, is that so it was always a distribution company. Somewhere in the beginning of this century, we developed a multi-brand retail and we set up a large number of stores in both categories. One is in mall and destination stores. And that's when we started growing as a retailer. We were always a distributor who then developed multi-brand retail as a strong part of our business. Today, it's a very powerful arm of our business. We believe long-term play is only there for omni-channel. There is no one-channel retailer who will survive. If you look at what Amazon is doing, it's becoming omni-channel. It acquired Whole Foods. It's acquiring retailers. I wouldn't be surprised before other online-only players buy brick-and-mortar retailers. And the brick-and-mortar retailers who don't have online presence won't survive. When we say omni, it's not just brick-and-mortar and e-commerce. There are other channels. There is chat as a channel. There is voice as a channel, call center-based sales. So there are many other channels. One element that has helped us tremendously is the digital transformation. And when I say digital transformation, I'm not just talking about omni-channel or e-commerce. Digital transformation is about deploying enabling technologies which deliver several outcomes, and I'll list the outcomes for you. One of the most important element of that outcome is better customer experience. So whether it is for service, whether it is in store, whether it's on our online channel, or it's our corporate customer, we are investing heavily in employing digital technologies to improve customer services and customer experience. By that, what I mean is, we have SLAs, service level agreements for our and KPIs for our teams, and these are measured through digital transformation, and we take strict action when there is a breach on SLAs, and we look at ways to improve these services. Second thing is, we are trying to cut the time to market. So we are integrating our supply chains
downstream and upstream. So downstream meaning with the factories and upstream with the customers. So we are making that digital. So we are in that process. Third and the most important is the objective is to be more competitive. Obviously cost and all that is always there, but these are the three core. While I told you that we are making large investments in enterprise, something that that we started post-COVID, which is very interesting, is that for every industry, we looked at what the new normal is. So we looked at all the large segments, and we said, what is the new normal in this? So we looked at hospitality, we looked at education, we looked at small businesses, we looked at retail, we looked at healthcare, we looked at government. And I'll give you an example of school. The new normal in school is very different. You need safe distancing. You need to be able to deliver online lectures. You need a different way of evaluating students. You need to be able to record the lectures. Students and their mothers should be able to archive and retrieve those lectures. Now all this puts pressure on your network infrastructure. So your existing network infrastructure won't do. Then there is a pressure on cash flow of the school because there is no fees being paid. So how is the school going to run? So we have come up with a solution for each industry to deal with the new normal. Some of the interesting things are that we've started an outsourcing service for the customers who are going who want to release cash which is trapped in their IT assets. So we would buy back that IT assets and lease it to them along with services. Okay. So it will become IT infrastructure as a service. So you focus on your core business of educating and we'll take care of your IT. Okay, and same similar thing for small businesses and hospitality.